to disassemble and reassemble a Nokia N8, you will need a T6 and a T5 Torx star type screwdriver, a small bladed screwdriver, a pair of tweezers, and a plastic knife. So first thing is to make sure it's switched off. And we need to remove the bottom cover. So take your T5 screwdriver and undo this screw about 3 or 4 turns. No need to take it out yet. It's about 3 or 4 turns. And just lift the bottom off. Now the bottom contains the GSM and 3G antenna. So if it's damaged or broken, you could find a few reception problems. Now the battery bar, just lift up this corner here and just lift it away and get hold of the battery and just pull it out. Now go back to your T5 screwdriver again and undo these two screws. Now they're not very tight to undo, so when you're doing backup, just do them finger tight, otherwise you'll snap them off. Now come to the top of the phone and open your HDMI port. You'll find a small black screw there. So going back to your T5 screwdriver again, just undo that screw. And it's quite a bit smaller than the others, so you can't really get mixed up. Now a lot of people have been having trouble pushing it off from the back, so I'll show you an alternative method here. Take a piece of sticky tape and just apply it along the top like that. Make sure this HDMI port is lifted out. Stem isn't sticking inside. And then bring this over so it sits on the top like that. And that gives you something to get hold of, and then you can just pull the top up and it comes off. Now we can undo these two screws. So back to your T5 screwdriver again. And these are the last two screws holding the screen on. Now before we remove the screen, just want to take off this Wi-Fi antenna. You just pop that up and it comes off nice and easy. And turn it over and just lift the screen up from the top. Now be careful here, this little rubber gasket sometimes falls off. It's for a secondary camera. So just lift it out, put that somewhere safe, and just open the screen up. And you need to unplug these two cables. So just pop that one up, like so. And the same again here, just unplug that. And there's your screen assembly. Now we've got three more screws to undo. These are slightly bigger, so use your T6 screwdriver to undo these two silver screws in the center. And if the small metal clips fall out at this stage, don't worry, I'll show you where they go when we put it back together. And then you've got a black self-tapping screw at the top here. It's quite a bit longer than the others, so you can't get it mixed up. Now we can lift the mainboard cover away from the body, like so. And these small little clips, they come off quite easy. Just put them somewhere safe. Now if you need to replace the earpiece, you need to use a sharp tool and just insert it here and then just prise the earpiece out and it comes out. Just held on with double-sided sticky tape. When you put it back in, you can't put it in the wrong way because it's got two small plastic lugs here. And they're a slightly different size each side, so they only go back in with the small lugs on this side. And if you need to replace the charging socket, that comes out like so, and then you could put your new one back in again. So now we can lift the main board away from the body. Before we do that, there's a little rubber gasket here for the proximity sensor. Sometimes that falls off, so just get hold of that and put that somewhere safe so you can't lose it. And that comes away. So that's your main board. Now we've got the loudspeaker. I suggest you use a plastic knife to lever this off because it's got quite a strong magnet on there and it'll attach itself to your screwdriver. Now be careful not to damage this surface because that could make your music a bit distorted. Now we've got the camera flash. So use your bladed screwdriver and just get your screwdriver in there and just lever that out. There's a small plastic clip just there that locates in that slot. So once you've lifted that up, you can take that off. Now, if you're replacing these covers, you can just take them out and they come out quite easy. So you can push it out from the back and just lift them out. Then we've got these little screws and nuts at the bottom here. These can be a bit fiddly. So take your T5 screwdriver and just hold that nut and undo that screw completely. And then the nut will just fall out, like so. The same here, to undo that screw. And the little nut just falls out. So now it's time for reassembly. So take one of these little nuts and hold it so it looks like that. Get hold of that little tab with your tweezers and just offer it up into the case like so. Now to keep it in place, you want to take the screw and just screw it into that nut just a few turns just to hold it in place. There you go. So that's that one done. Same again this side. Get hold of your little nuts and hold that part there and just offer it up into the case so it looks like that. And again, get your screw and just do it up a few turns just to hold it in while you put it back together. Don't do it fully up. Then we've got the SIM card cover, so just put your SIM card cover back in again. Making sure that little rubber lug is sitting nicely. And then you've got your memory card. Let's put that in. And just making sure that those little rubber tabs are sitting there. Now we can put the loudspeaker back in. It doesn't matter which way around you put it. So if you put it around this way or this way, it will work both ways. Push that into place. Then you've got your camera flash. This silver part is the capacitor. Just put that in first and then push that down until it clicks into place. Now we're ready to put the main board back on again. So offer up the main board with the micro USB lined up at the top. And don't push it down just yet. We need to line up this switch with the screen lock switch. So at the moment it's not lined up. So if you line it up, you can see that's now working okay. So before we put the next part on, we need to put the proximity sensor gasket on. Just get hold of that. And put it on that way around so the two little holes are at the bottom. And make sure your headphone socket is sitting in nicely, which it is. And take your mainboard cover and just offer that up. Now we need to put those silver screws, the self-tapping screws, back into the center holes. Using the larger T6 screwdriver. And now we've got that slightly longer black self-tapping screw in the top here. And then we've got these small silver clips to go in. I'll try and get nice and close for this. You need to hold it so that the little hooks are facing towards you, and then offer that up into the little groove there and push that down until it goes completely flush. So I guess that's completely flush now. The same with the other side. Get the little hooks facing you and then offer it up into that groove and then push it down. You can use a screwdriver if you want to. Just push that down until it goes completely flush, which it is. Now before we put the screen on, we need to put that little rubber gasket back on the secondary camera. Now it's got a little flat corner, and the flat corner goes towards the corner of the phone. So just drop that onto there, like so. And now take your screen plugs and offer them up and try and get it nice and straight and just push them into place. If you get it lined up, they go on quite easy. It can be a bit fiddly. So that one's gone on. And now we've got the LCD screen plug here. Again, just try and line it up as best you can and push it gently into place. You'll feel it pop on there. Now we've got to make sure this chipboard slides underneath that ribbon cable, which it has done. And I'm just going to final check to make sure that plug's pushed on, which it is. Yep, they're both okay. So carefully bring the screen down, making sure that rubber gasket's in place, and then turn it over and put these four threaded screws in each corner. And then back to your T5 screwdriver. Just do these screws up finger tight. And while we're at the top here, we'll put the Wi-Fi antenna back on again. So have the little gold contact towards this connector here and just push that into place, like so. Then we want to put the top cover back on. So just offer that up and make sure it's nice and flush along the back there. Then remove the sellotape. And make sure this moves freely in and out. If it's trapped, then just take the top cover off and make sure this is pulled fully out when you put it back on. Then take that small black self-tapping screw and put it into the top hole here using your T5 screwdriver. Don't do it up too tight because you'll just strip it. That's fine. Then come to the bottom, put the battery back in with the gold connectors on this side. And the battery bar, put the T-piece in that little hole there. Put that back into place. Then take the bottom and just offer that up, and it should just go into place. Now you've got a bit of a space there at the moment, but if you take your T5 screwdriver, hold that down and just do that up. And again, hold that down. And that's it. It's all back together again. So please give me the thumbs up. Any comments or suggestions, do so below. And I'll try my best to make some more in the future. Thanks for watching.